Hello, my YouTube friends. Welcome to this exciting lesson on this channel. In this lesson, I just want to show you something, you know, quick, and that is how you can export your model from ETABS to Revit. Now, what you are seeing here is the model that you want to export to Revit. And you see that if I just go to Revit there, there's nothing here. So the question that you can ask me is that, why do you have to do this? Now, the short answer is that you may have on your team someone who is working in Revit and others are working in ETABS. The other reason is that in Revit, you are able to do the detailing according to your office standards. I know in ETABS, you're also able to produce those details, but you know, for you to customize it, you have to take it to a different software, and you don't want to waste that time because you want to take everything to Revit, including the reinforcement, and do the detailing, because Revit has the capability to produce details according to your office standard. It does, you know, you are able to customize it in any way. So if you like what I'm doing on this channel, please support me. Don't just watch my videos. If you like my videos and subscribe, that way you're supporting me and my channel will grow. And that way I'll be able to produce more and more content. So let me not waste time. Let's get started in this lesson. So here we are. This is the model that we are going to, you know, to take to Revit. This model is already analyzed. It also has some reinforcement within it. It has some loads and some load combinations. All right. Now, the purpose of this lesson is to export to Revit so that someone who is working within Revit can, you know, start the detailing without reworking or remodeling everything here, because you don't want to waste time, you know, to start modeling whatever has already been modeled in an analysis software like ETABS. All right. So what I'm going to do is to just go to File and I'll go to Export and just pick revitstructure.exr. Just click on it. Then just find where you can save this file. I'll go to this folder and I'll just, you know, overwrite that one and just click on save and simply click on yes. Now click on OK. All right. So you just give it a bit of time. It's going to save that file and I'm sure it has already saved. And all you need to do is to go to Revit within here and you see that there's nothing here. Now I want to mention that you in Revit, you have to install a plugin called, you know, CSI Cross Revit, and it goes with the version. So the one that I've installed is for Revit 2023. And once you install it, go to add-ins and you see that you find this, you know, to here where you're able to, you know, to create a new ETABS, you know, export to create new ETABS, safe or sub 2000, meaning that you are able to create everything here and just, you know, export to these free softwares. You are able to update existing ETABS or safe or sub 2000. You can also import. These are the two options. Okay. Now, the first one is the one you're going to use. The other option is the one after you want maybe to, you know, to update your model. Even after bringing it from ETABS to Revit, you want to update again the one which is in ETABS, you can use this option. So what I'll do, I'll just pick this one because I want to bring in my file here and it has gone to my folder. Just select on it, click on open. Now you just need to give it a bit of time. From here, you can see that these are the settings that you need to counter check. You can bring in the grids, the frames. The frames also includes the beams and columns. We don't have the walls, we have the floors. So these are going to be activated if you have them in your model. We see you're able to bring in reinforcement. And in my case, I don't want to bring in reinforcement. You can bring in your line loads, area loads, load combination. You know, this is very, very good and important. As I said, you're able to do all these within Revit and take this to ETABS. You can start with ETABS, do everything there, bring to Revit. So depending on where, how comfortable you are in either ETABS or Revit, you can start from anywhere and, you know, start, you know, moving this model from one software to the other without, you know, wasting time in redoing some of the things. So from here, these are the other options. If I just go to frames, I can now match the sections. This is the column. I can map it there. You can select and pick, you know, what you want to match with. You can make sure, just make sure that within your template in Revit, you know the members that you want to match with here. So I'll just leave it by default. See, we have the beam here. You can match it with the beams that you want to match with. That is the family, of course. These are families and the family type. Okay, even the braces, I'll just click on OK. You can do the same for the walls, you know, the floors and also the rebar. I'll not waste too much time here. I'll just click on OK and let's see what we have within Revit here. So as you can see, it's quite fast and we are going to have our model from ETABS to Revit, and it can also be from Sub 2000, you know, and other CSI softwares are able to do this. So data transfer is complete. I'll just click on OK. As you can see, the model is here in Revit. I'll just click on the 3D view. As you can see, we have the model right here and with the loads and the analytical model. If I just change from here to shaded, you can see that we have it here. I can go to the analytical model, this view here, you see we have it here. If I want, just go to VG to remove the loads. I can do that from here. I think I have the loads. Let me just counter check structural loads right there. Apply. Okay. And we see we just have the analytical model. As I said, the analytical model can also be started from Revit, including the model, and then you take it to ETABS. So this is okay. This is good. Let me just remove the loads for this one. Just go there and structural loads. Apply. Okay. Then I also have the analytical there appearing. I can even use at the bottom hide analytical and you see that we have the model. Then VG to remove the levels, L on my keyboard for levels, click there, apply, okay, and see that we have it there. So as I mentioned, you may want to do this. You have someone working within here. You want to start detailing, producing general arrangement drawings. Okay, you want to produce GS within Revit. ETABS may not give you all the GS that you want and you may not customize it within there. So if you want to do it in Revit, you can bring it here, and from here now you can start doing whatever you want to do within, you know, Revit. As you can see, you can start now annotating from here. Again, I have a lot of lessons on this channel where you can see how you can start annotating within here. You can go to annotate, you know, start tagging. This is a column. Again, I will not talk about the tagging now. Otherwise, the most important thing is that you're able to bring in this one and you can export it back to ETABS. So thanks for watching. Stay on this channel and like my videos.